Welcome back. Now, Kundan Shah's cult classic Jaane Bido Yaaro continues to entertain casual watchers and film buffs alike. From spouting some of its crackling one-liners to dissecting them to the level of metaphors and symbols, we've all had fun watching it, talking about it, and watching it yet again. And guess what? Now you can read about it too. You know enough about Jaane Bido Yaaro, you can write a scholarly treatise on it? Well, too late. Blogger and journalist Jai Arjun Singh has already done it and with fairly good results. Jaane Bido Yaaro, seriously funny since 1983, is a delectable monograph on the film we know a lot about. But keep revisiting it in a hope to read something new or different in it or to simply unearth some obscure trivia. We talked to the author at the Jaipur Literature Festival and began the interview by asking him why we don't have enough scholarship on cinema as prolific as ours.
Well, I think there have been books on individual films before. There have been books on films like Sholay, Awara, Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge. But HarperCollins has now started this series of film books. So hopefully this will change. But I imagine writing a whole book on a single film is something that a lot of people find the idea a bit odd.
Doing this book on Jaane Bido Yaaro, was it your idea or was it something that your publisher suggested? And why Jaane Bido Yaaro?
This was a commission project. Like I said, HarperCollins is doing the series of film books. We decided to think about films that I could work on, and Jaane Bido Yaaro was one of the titles that came up. But I immediately realized that it would be a very interesting film to write about because there's so many talking points. It's a slapstick comedy. It uses various modes of comedy, and also the people who made it, the cast and the crew, comprise some of the most talented theatre and film the people of that generation. And I thought the process of making a low budget film like this, which wasn't a box office hit, but became a huge cult hit eventually, would be interesting. It would be very insightful.
How did you go about collecting material, interviews, research?
I met the most of the unit. The most important person for me was undoubtedly Kundan Shah, the writer-director of the film, in whose mind the film was conceived. For me, this book was always going to be a partly journalistic project. There's some analysis, but it's journalistic in the sense that it tells the story of the making of the film, the behind-the-scenes story, and for that, obviously, I had to speak to a lot of people.
What is your one favorite bit from the film that people may not know about?
There's this little scene, just a 5-second scene, where you have these two security guards in a hall. A rat is running around, and they shoot the rat dead. I mean, you just hear a gunshot, then you see them walking around with the dead rat in their hands. The idea is that this place is so heavily guarded that chuha bhi nahi aa sakta andar.
Right.
The behind-the-scenes story for that is that Pavan Malhotra, who's today a well-known actor, but he was working as a junior production assistant on the film, he had to actually go to a Bombay Municipal Corporation warehouse and collect the dead bodies of rats to be brought for the shoot, and then keep them in an air-conditioned room because it was May. So those are silly little things that go into the making of even a split-second moment that can make you laugh in a film.
And any other film that you have planned in the same series?
I have other favorites. There's this silent Kamal Hassan film called Pushpak, which I was a big fan of. I would have loved to do maybe not a very big book, but a slim book on that film. There are mainstream Hindi films. There's one very interesting mainstream Hindi film which hasn't got talked about much, a 1989 J.P. Datta film called Hathiyar, which had Sanjay Dutt, young Sanjay Dutt in it, and Dharmendra and Rishi Kapoor in very interesting roles. It was a very mature for its time film about the underworld.
So there you go. If you too like reading behind-the-scenes stories of movies, there's a lot coming your way. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Life and Style. Remember, you can write into us on lifeandstyle@utvmoney.com with all your thoughts and feedback. You can even join us on Twitter. Our Twitter handle is flashing on your screen. We'll see you again next week with yet another lineup that'll make sure you live it up in style, of course.